glad to have you with us in the studio. I'm Reese Davis, bringing you the EA Sports NCAA Football 14 pregame show presented by Nissan. Innovation that excites. Early season, mid-season, late season, it really doesn't matter. The SEC doesn't wait to turn up the intensity. An early season matchup in the Southeastern Conference. That's going to do it for us here on the pregame show. NCAA Football 14 action coming at you right now. Fred Nessler and Kirk Herbstreit.
And the fans are on their feet awaiting the start of this game as the players line up for the kick. Sullivan from the six. He's pushed out of bounds at midfield.
Auburn staff and their fans have heard all week long their quarterback's going to play terribly on the road. I think their staff's got them ready to prove them wrong right now.
I think this staff really has rallied this entire team around some of that negative talk. And I think they believe in their guy that he can go on the road and make the plays and lead them to a big victory. You know, sometimes when you hit some adversity like that, you see teams circle the wagons. And I really believe this week they've done a great job of doing that. Now they just have to go out and execute the plan and go out and win this game.
Gains his way to the 30-yard line. He kept it himself and picked up a good-looking first down.
Great execution and a good decision there by the quarterback.
Second down and 10 to go. Ball on the 30. Pulls it in, and he's in the open field. He's tackled at the 20. Caught, and he steps out of bounds.
The offense gets a first down here, and you got to give them some credit. But really, this is more about the defense. When a defense gets an offense to third down and medium, you've got to be able to put pressure on a quarterback, especially when they're passing the football, and try to get your own offense the ball back. And that time, they let their own offense down.
Gets it out to his receiver in a hurry. What a play to set him up with a first and goal.
That's pretty impressive. Accuracy is important, but just as important is having receivers that can make plays.
Touchdown, Tigers. And he converts the extra point. Go to the studio for this Reese Davis update.
You won't miss a thing of what's going on in the top 10. And for Missouri, they're looking to win their third straight. Missouri in front, 7-0.
All right, Reese, back to our game. The Auburn is lining up to kick this one off. He's to the 20. And he's tackled at the 29.
Pick up
The quarterback brings his troops out onto the field for the first drive of the game. He's going to try and scramble. And he's taken down around the 31-yard line.
That makes it second and eight.
From their own 31-yard line, second down. Now he's scrambling. Now he's going to run and watch out. And he's tackled at the 44-yard line. Pressure, and that one's incomplete.
There was just no way anybody could catch up with that pass.
That makes it second and 10.
From their own 44-yard line, it's second down. Defense goes with the extra defensive backs as the offense comes up five wide. Scrambling around. And they make the stop at about the 47-yard line. Down, 10 to go. Ball on the 40-yard line. He goes out of bounds around the 38-yard line.
That makes it second and eight.
He's on the run, brought down at the 34-yard line.
That'll make it 35.
And here's another third down. So an empty backfield with five wide receivers. Now he tries to buy some time. They'll bring him down around the 32-yard line.
And he didn't get much on that scramble before they drilled him.
Brad, that's a great way for the quarterback to get himself injured. He needs to be a lot more careful out there.
Kicks away. And it's good. And he's got to be happy about that kick.
Oh, no question. This kid is just a solid kicker.
7-3, Auburn. Matthew has his kick team lined up, and he is set to kick this one off. Gathered in at the 6. And down he goes at the 25-yard line. The offense ready for the first play of this drive. They moved the ball extremely well on their last possession on their way to the end zone.
You know, when this defense went over the sideline based on the way they've been playing so far, this defense coordinator's got to be livid. He's got to get in their face.
Loose football. That was a close one, but the ball goes out of bounds. It's second down, 6 to go. Ball in the 29. Auburn is up 4. He fights forward to about the 29. He's scrambling. No one open, so he's going to run. He's taken down at the 39.
First down.
He steps out at about the 45.
That's a gain of 6 on the play. That'll make it second and 4.
Hit out of bounds around the 47-yard line. gets out to around the 38.
This kind of execution from an offense can really affect the defense and their psyche. That's the second time on this drive alone they've been able to convert on a third down. This defense has got to be able to kind of gather themselves and try to find some confidence. And somebody on that defense has got to be able to make a play to slow this offense down.
Here's the eighth play of the series. He scrambled. Fumble! And the offense will recover.
Close one there. Maybe the ball carrier will try a little harder to secure the ball next time.
Third down, and they need to get it to the 28. Auburn is up by four. Looks like we're going to have a good game on our hands after one. The Tigers lead it by four. And we're ready for more football here in quarter number two. These special teams have done it before, blocking punts. It looks like they're coming after this one. This one will go into the end zone, and they'll bring it out to the 20. In a game that's this close, you can't afford to waste possessions. They'll spread the field here. Let's see what the defense does with a five wide out look. There's a strike complete. He's down.
Jacobson's in some zone, but the 24-yard line. That makes it second and six.
From their own 24-yard line. Second down. The offense going to try to open this field up, coming out in a five wide set. And the defense counters with their dime look. Fires quickly, and he's got his man. And down he goes at the 36-yard line.
That makes it first and 10.
He's going to try and scramble. And they got him. Kirk's the kind of player that keeps defensive coordinators up late at night, Herbie. I mean, if you load the box and take away the run, he's going to go up on top. If you sit back in the zone, he'll kill you with his legs. I mean, he's a great player. So the sack makes this a second and long. And he's stopped behind the line.
Is a loss of 4 yards. That'll bring up third and long.
Tight end right. Tight end right.
Three down, three down.
Check 59. Three down.
He fires. Complete. It's the junior. Tackle made at the 36. And the big pickup through the air has made it first and 10.
Four down. Check 59. Mike is 59.
Yeah. Here we go.
Now he's scrambling. And he is drilled at the 26-yard line.
That's a deep 10. That brings him second and 9.
Man, left.
Nice run, and he's brought down. And this is the eighth play of the drive.
Here we go.
And he's going to lose big yardage. He's tackled. tackled immediately after the catch. They're stopped for a 5-yard loss.
Well, that's just a sound play by the defense. They dropped him well short of the line of scrimmage.
Second down, 15 to go. Ball on the 26. At about the 23-yard line.
That brings up third and 12.
This is the 10th play of this drive. Fires quickly. Touchdown. So the kicker will line up here and try to give his team a 3-point lead with this extra point. And he tacks on the extra point. Reese Davis is standing by with this update. Reese?
Off to University Park we go. Check out these two teams keeping it close. UTEP out front, 10-7.
And we thank you, Reese Davis. Back to the action here. Tulane is ready to kick it away. He's to the 20. Tackle made at the 31-yard line. There hasn't been too much daylight between these two teams. In games like this, some players try to press too much, and that can cause mistakes. And he just gets rid of it.
Brad, I just think this quarterback's got to do a much better job of being able to read that defense and make quicker decisions. And especially when the defense starts to get pressure, you've got to either get rid of that football or check it down or take off and run with it.
Looks for the tight end, but they can't hook up. We've got third and 10. Ball on the 31-yard line. He wants it all, going long. That close to being intercepted.
Let's see if the momentum from that defensive stand carries over to their offense.
They've got 10 guys up. They're coming after the kick. Miles fields it at the 38. They'll bring him down at the 43. Momentum swings have been fairly even, and with so little separation, this game can be drastically changed on just one or two plays. Tulane holds a field goal lead. And he's tackled in the open field. Kirk gets 6 yards after taking it himself. Tulane's going to take their first time out of the half. So it's second down now, and they need about 4 yards to pick up the first. There to stop him.
That's a gain of 3 on the play. That'll make it 31.
Runs it and tackled in the backfield.
Call a loss of 1 yard on the play. That'll make it 4th and 2.
The punting team's got to give their kickers some time. He's got the corner. He fields it at the 17. And they push him out right around the 26-yard line. In a game that's this close, you can't afford to waste possessions. He's tackled at the 37.
I like how efficient the offense looked on that play. Everybody knew their assignment, and it all came together for a nice run.
First and 10. Ball on their own 37. And we'll probably see how far he can throw it, as it should be the last play before the half. Wants to go long and does. Incomplete.
That makes it second and 10.
Great game in the works, folks, as we come to the end of the first half. 10-7, Greenway.
Hi, everybody. Glad to have you with us on the EA Sports NCAA Football 14 Halftime Show, presented by Nissan. Innovation that excites. Davis, David Pollack here in the studio, as always, to lend a little perspective to what just went down in the first 30 minutes.
I'm a fan of seeing guys one-step wrap, two-step squeeze, bring your feet, arrive with bad intentions. I don't want to take anything away from these defensive guys, David. But could this be that we're seeing a healthy dose of some pretty bad offense, too?
It goes hand in hand, doesn't it, Reese?
Sometimes,
pretty good defense makes, you know, average offenses look really, really bad. But, you know, when you have a great defense and you can take something away, especially the strength of the other offense, and make them do things that they don't do exceptionally well. And, you know, don't let them throw the fastball. Make them throw the curve. I mean, you see great defenses be able to do that all the time. And that's when you can be ultra successful. You have to find ways to make people play, you know, the game out of their comfort zone.
Just about time to start the second half. What do you think Herb Street's first point of analysis will be?
Something to do with quarterback play, I'm sure. I mean, always got to hear that stuff all the time. It's all about the quarterbacks.
Brad and Kirk ready for the second half.
All right, Reese, David, thanks, guys. Just about set to start the third quarter. He kicks it off, and he got all of that one. This one's going to be down in the end zone for a touchback. They are ready to begin another drive. Tulane is up by three. Goes to the receiver, incomplete.
West the intended receiver on the way. That makes it second and 10.
From their own 25-yard line, it's second down. And he's taken down at the 45. Good pitch and catch there on second down.
Yep, it was good enough to get him a first down. That's just a nice play.
Goal line set. Pitts gets the ball. He's at the 40. Inside the 30. The 10. Touchdown. Big play. Once this kid gets into the open field, you're not going to catch him.
You know, some of his critics say that all he has is track speed. Well, let me tell you, speed is speed, as we just saw right there.
Splits the uprights with the extra point. A quick update now. Here's Reese.
Time to get you up to date on some scores from around the country. This one's been entertaining us all day long. And for SMU, here's a team that's been ice cold. And for Johnson, he scored a touchdown. The Mustangs are on top, 20-17. Middle of the second quarter.
10-point game here, Reese, 17-7. Everyone's all lined up and ready for the kickoff. Sullivan fields it at the 11, and he's taken down at the 26. Tulane's the type of team, when you look at them, it looks like their defense sort of just feeds off itself.
I think the energy is there, Brad, but I think it really starts up front with their defensive line and their linebackers. The way they're being able to just win the battle at the line of scrimmage, I think it's giving them confidence, and it's allowing them to play more downhill where they can attack this offense.
He's on the run. He's to the 40. diving for extra yardage.
A good quarterback knows when and how to improvise. And if he's got the skills, he can also turn a scramble into something big.
Straight ahead on the give, and there's nowhere to run. From their own 45-yard line, second down. Down at the 46.
Jones on the tackle with the 46-yard line. That makes it 33.
And it's caught, and they make the stop at the 35.
This isn't even the best example, but I'm going to tell you something. This young man is really getting better at running his routes, which is a truly underrated quality these days.
Goes out to the tight end again, completes. And he's tackled at the 23.
First down.
He gets out to about the 14-yard line.
That'll make it 7 inches.
He's taken down at about the 3-yard line. He had nowhere to go on that option play.
Boy, you're right. He's lucky he held onto the football there.
This is the ninth play of this drive. Touchdown, Tigers.
When you're that close to the end zone, it's always a smart play to find your blockers and follow them into the end zone.
Trying to get within a field goal. They'll try the point after. And he hits the PAT. Time for an update from the studio. Reese, what have you got?
Time for an update from University Park. Let's take yet another peek at this game. The Mustangs' rushing attack can be difficult to stop, and they get into the end zone for a touchdown. SMU in front, 27-24.
Separated by a field goal here, Reese, 17-14 in our game. Auburn is lining up to kick this one off. He's to the 20. He makes it out to maybe the 23-yard line. Kirk, not sure what went on in the locker room at halftime, but both offenses have really come ready to play in this third quarter.
I think that's really what separates a good team from a great team, is being able to make the adjustments at halftime and to come out and being able to execute. And so far, we've seen both these offenses able to do that.
Pretty good looking touchdown drive the last time these guys were out there. Tulane is up a field goal. He's scrambling. Now he's going to run and watch out. They'll bring him down at the 30-yard line. That scramble gets them 7 yards.
That makes it second and two.
It's second down, and they're about 2 yards away from the sticks. Left, and he's taken down in the backfield.
Loss of two on the play. That'll bring up third and four.
Him hard at the 32.
That makes it
fourth and inches.
Matthews awaits the snap. He makes it out to maybe the 43-yard line.
The last time out, they were able to pick up big chunks of yards through the air. You wonder if they'll go back to that same strategy, or will they start to lean a little bit more on their ground game?
He goes out of bounds at the 47. Wide. Scrambling around. That's a great tackle at the 40-yard line.
Gain 13 on the play. First down.
Down he goes, right around the 32-yard line.
That makes it second and two.
Let's go! Green and
yellow! One play and he'll lose yards. About 4 yards away here on third down. Fires out to his receiver, and he's level at the 21.
That's a gain of 13 on the play. That makes it first and 10.
Slings it. Tackle made at the 22. One more quarter of action remaining, and this one has been a real treat. Tulane's got a 3-point lead. Well, this final 2 minutes is going to determine this one. Tight ball game. Action set to start here in the fourth quarter. We're still early in the fourth quarter, but that was a huge stop. And now with the lead, they're going to get the football back and an opportunity to stretch the lead. After the sack, it's now fourth and long. Throw incomplete, one of his receiver.
It's always a gamble going for it with so many yards to come up with. But when you're behind, sometimes you have to take risks to get back into a ball game.
Things aren't tied, but they might as well be. It's this drive that could really dictate the tone for the last quarter. Tulane has a 3-point lead. Quick out to his receiver. Tackled at the 33-yard line.
Second and five.
From their own 33-yard line, second down. Throws it in a hurry. He's knocked out of bounds, right around the 42-yard line. Pickup.
That's a gain of seven. That'll bring up second and three.
Second down, and they're going to need about 3 yards to pick up the first down. Tackle very well, could have saved the touchdown. From the 30-yard line, first down. Just under three to go in regulation. Got some pressure and forced a bad pass.
I think they've been a little bit more aggressive here with their pass rush, and that time it paid off with an incompletion.
Second down, 10 to go. Ball on the 30-yard line. Finds his man, and they take him down immediately. The Tigers taking their first time out of the half. And this play is number 8 on the drive. Tries to buy some time, runs with it, and he's got room. He's tackled at the 15.
I'm telling you, quarterbacks who can run the ball are so hard to stop. You have to scheme around them, which takes the best coverages out of your defensive playbook.
From the 15-yard line, first down. He's hit immediately.
You can tell he's got a lot of faith in his wide receivers. Even when he's a little bit off target, they can pull it in and make something happen.
10th play of the drive. Tries to get out of trouble, but he can't shake the defense. Third down again. Less than 2 minutes in the fourth quarter.
Here we go, here we go, here we go. Green nine.
Go. Go. Now he's scrambling. And he tackles him hard at the 3. First and goal from the 2, and they can smell the end zone. Scrambled, and he's going to be sacked. He just blew past the blockers and dragged the quarterback down.
Boy, excellent play by the defense here. A few extra seconds, and those receivers might have been open.
Thirteenth play of the drive coming up.
In your face.
And this should be a kneel down as they just try to kill the clock. Nothing more demoralizing for a defense than seeing the opposing quarterback take a knee.
this one's all but wrapped up with the final score, 17-14, Tulane. For EA Sports and Kirk Herbstreit, this is Brad Nessler saying thanks for tuning in, and we'll see you next time.